Judgment of $4,500 is hereby rendered to the plaintiff. This case is now closed. Clerk, will you please call the next case?
Next case on the docket, Thompson versus Clunk.
Can I come in?
Where have you been? We're about to start.
It took forever for them to let me in, okay? They thought I was a kid sitting on another kid's shoulders.
Your suit.
It's a little big. I know, okay, I had to get one at Goodwill because
I'm locked out of your closet, I forgot.
The door slide, and there's a shoe blocking it at a perfect angle, one of my brown Merrells.
This court will come to order as it is now in session. In this case, complaint is from the plaintiff in the amount of $7,000. Plaintiff Rick Thompson claims that Miss Violet Clunk, the defendant—
Mrs. Clunk.
My apologies.
It's fine. He's not here because he's an actor, and he's out of town filming in Ireland, which is crazy. And I lost my ring on a roller coaster.
Mr. Thompson further seeks property damage to his vehicle as well as medical expenses resulting from the care and treatment of his injury. Mr. Thompson, it is your burden, so you may speak.
Thank you, Your Honor. Yes. On March 22nd, at 2:16 p.m., Mr. Thompson was driving south down Pendleton Road, not a cloud in the sky. And as Mrs. Clonk's car passed his, going in the opposite direction, the sun reflected off her forehead, going directly into my client's eyes, temporarily blinding him. He swerved off the road and crashed into a telephone pole.
Excuse me, Mr. Thompson, the reflection came from her forehead?
He believes so, Your Honor.
It was very shiny, maybe from oil or sweat.
So is it your claim that Mrs. Clon's forehead was so shiny that the sun bounced off of it into Mr. Thompson's eyes, causing him to veer off the road and crash?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Okay, that's ludicrous. I use mattifying toner.
Objection. Move to strike Mrs. Clonk's statement.
Sustained.
What the freaking hell?
Mr. Thompson, I understand you have a video you'd like to present to the court.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you. As you can see, Mr. Thompson is driving south at approximately 40 miles per hour, and Mrs. Clonk is driving north at about 95 miles per hour. Plaintiff arrests, Your Honor.
The sun must have reflected off the amulet that I was wearing.
Based on an Instagram story that Mrs. Clonk posted approximately 10 minutes before my client's accident, we can clearly see she is not wearing any necklace.
Just like a star across the sky, just like an angel off the page, you have appeared in my life. Feels like I'll never be the same, just like the song in my heart, just like oil in my hands.
As a point of clarification, are you claiming that the telephone pole you crashed into not only damaged your vehicle, but electrocuted you as well?
Correct. And now phones don't work around me.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Hey, eyes on me. None of that, all right? Breathe, I want you to breathe. I got this, okay? I'm gonna win this for us.
Defendants, your response?
We're gonna win this, okay?
First of all, thank you so much for having me, Your Honor. I promise to tell the truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God. I may not be the best lawyer or a lawyer, but I promise to do everything in my power to defend my client here today. Also, it might surprise you at this point in my speech that I used to have a stutter.
Thank you, Mr. Clonk. You may proceed.
People of the court, how would you feel if someone told you your forehead was shiny? That your forehead was so disgustingly oily that the sun could reflect off of it with the power of a hand mirror? That is what Mr. Thompson is accusing my client, Violet Clonk, of here today. Let me tell you, I'd be pissed. And I was pissed because I knew my client was innocent. All right, I have known Mrs. Clonk for many, many years, and I can tell you she has the driest forehead I've ever seen. It is in fact so dry that if you lit a match within 50 feet of it, it would burst into flames. But it wasn't always this way. This is my client in eighth grade.
Oh my God.
Soak it up. They didn't call her pimple c- for nothing. Not at all. And let me tell you, my mom tried everything. Everything. It's actually kind of weird now that I think about it, because we have the same parents and I had really good skin in high school and she didn't. I'm so sorry. I lost my train of thought. What was I saying again?
You have the same parents.
Right. Yes. Frick.
Thank you, Mr. Klonk. You may sit.
What the f- was that?
I blacked out there, to be honest. But I think we might still have a 50-50 chance. Did you film me?
Are you joking me? No!
What? The only reason I agreed to do this was to get B-roll for my short film.
I don't care.
All the flashback scenes take place in a courtroom, dumbass.
You're fired. I'll take it from here, Your Honor.
That's not how this works.
What, like it's hard?
I've seen and heard enough. I'm able to render my decision.
Your Honor, please, if I just may say a few words.
As I just said, I've
all right! Kiddos, cat's out of the bag, huh? Maybe the sun did reflect off my forehead and into his eyes. You know what? Maybe it did. And, I'm really sorry. I'm like so sorry. Is that what you want? An apology?
No.
However, did you ever once stop and see it from my point of view? Did you ever once consider that maybe this was self-defense?
We saw the video.
Sure. Yeah. That video. Incredible editing. Just wow. Tried to pull the wool over our eyes. What you all don't know is that that video, sorry, actually took place at night.
Objection!
Okay, fine! Fine! I confess! Are you happy? You know what, guys? Here's the deal. Don't have $7,000, okay? I've literally never had that much money. I've had $400. That's it. And I lost it all physically.
Mrs. Klonk.
Wait! Please. Who?
Enough. Be seated.
So?
Directed not to speak.
Oh my God.
Judgment in favor of Mr. Thompson in the amount of $7,000 for property damage and medical expenses related to the crash. This case is now closed.
What? Oh my God.
Just like a star across my sky, just like an angel off the page, you have appeared to my life.